Are you thinking of moving to Chicago? Do you like tall buildings? How about 30-minute commutes to work? Winters that make you want to send it to the Mojave Desert? How about snow up your ass? Maybe that one's too far. Then you should move to Chicago. That was great. I'm so tired right now. I feel like my eyes are probably drooping. Hi, my name is Brooke. Oh my god. Hi. My name is Brooke Walding. Hi. My name is Brooke Walding. Anyways, shall we begin? I'm currently living in East Lakeview, Chicago. I moved here about 3 years ago and I've been in this apartment since I moved here. Lots of ups and downs, and I am going to give you all the points why I like Chicago and why I don't. So let's just get into it. How did I end up in Chicago? Well, the story begins 3 years ago when a senior year Brooke was graduating from the University of Iowa, unsure of what the heck I wanted to do, where I wanted to go. So I asked my friends, where are you guys going? And they were like, yo, we're going to Chicago. And I was like, I wanna go to a big city that's not in Iowa. And so I ended up in Chicago. Yes, it's a very riveting story. That does bring me to my first con of Chicago. That's getting a job here. It's really hard. Competitive as hell. It is difficult. Very competitive job market. The first thing you should be thinking about when you move to a new city is a job. I think that's what most people are thinking about when they move to a city, I would assume. But to credit senior year Brooke, she definitely thought about that. I just misjudged that it would be much easier to get a job in Chicago. I thought, hey, it's a big city, lots of job opportunities, which is true in almost every industry. There's options all around, but there's also a lot of competition. You're up against so many people, definitely people that are more qualified than a college student. So that was hard. It took me 4 months to get a job, maybe five. Maybe six. I had to get other jobs in the meanwhile. I worked at a boutique on Southport. I babysat. I worked for a liquor company. You know a lot of people and you're really well qualified and you find a job before moving here, you'll be fine. Just fair warning, especially for the college students that are trying to move into the city. So yeah, the job market isn't as lush as you would think. And I'm pretty sure some stats to back that.
All right, let's do some research here. Best places to find a job in 2021. And there you have it. We find Chicago, Illinois coming in at 147th on the list.
Next is the insane amount of humans. Yes, that's also a reason I moved here. I like being around people, hustle bustle. You can walk outside and feel like not alone, especially if you live by yourself. I don't live by myself. I imagine if I did, I could go outside and be like, okay, people are out and about. I'm not the only one on this earth. Trying to do anything here is really difficult because of the amount of people. Every corner you turn, every place you go, there are people. You can't go to the park and just enjoy your own space. People are watching you. Every move you do, there's someone watching. It gets to be a lot, and maybe because I'm from Des Moines, Iowa, I'm not used to that, and I can go out into the middle of the woods and dancing on my own. It gets to be a lot. Grocery shopping here is, it's like that game show. You know which one I'm talking about? Get
that. She's grabbing a grill. That's 300. The highest card total can win $100,000.
That's what grocery shopping here is like. Also, you go to Jewel Osco, one of the grocery stores here, and they ask if you play Monopoly at the counter when you're checking out your groceries. They are not asking if you play the board game Monopoly. They're asking if you want coupons to the groceries. The first time I ever got here, the first time I ever went to Jewel Osco, they asked me that, and I was like, I mean, I think the last time I played was when I was 10. And he was like, no, coupons. And I'm like, oh, now you know. Doing anything around here with that amount of people, it's absurd. Next point, it's so cold here.
Freezing. 11 degrees below zero right now in Chicago.
So cold, Lake Michigan looks more like a hot tub. When it gets this cold,
you can stay in today, stay in all day.
So yeah, if you want to be cold 6 months out of the year, that is something to expect. And be cooped up in your apartment. You can be warm as long as you wear 8 coats. I don't wanna wear 8 coats. Prepare for a lot of snow. It's been snowing like every day for the past like 5 days. So take a look what it looks like when it does that here. Wow.
The only good thing about snow is we can have more friends in the neighborhood.
The cold is just, I'm really over it. But the summer is awesome here.
Oh,
Can we put the sunroof up or does it not go? Oh yeah. Dad, you closed it.
That's up.
No, I want it. Does it open?
Yeah, you mean you want it down?
Yeah, can you put sunroof down? Crazy. So crazy that it's a little exhausting because everyone's trying to get as much fun as they can out of those 6 months, that it's overwhelming and you spend a ton of money. Then in the winter, you don't do anything. You save your money. So it's a weird, just try to balance the two. Other reason, it's expensive. I mean, you're in a city. Better than some cities. It's not like New York or LA, but it's not cheap. Pretty much give away a ton of money to rent and just other things that come along with the city. You're gonna spend a lot more money here because there's a lot more to do. But whether that be the good food that there is in Chicago, going to the museum, the festivals, the art festivals, checking out the different neighborhoods, shopping, going to the bars, the drinks are so expensive. You just tend to spend your money more in the city and everything else that you already have to pay for. Your rent, having a car, all that stuff is also amped up. So what else? If you have a car in Chicago, that's expensive. I did not have a car for the first 2 years. Really didn't need it, especially with the public transportation here. I was fine to get to work, which is all I really needed it for. Parking, you're gonna be looking at $150 to $250. Any tickets, they'll just blow the roof off, honestly. The tickets here are insane. I wouldn't recommend a car, especially when you first move here. I would just test it out, see what the city's like without a car. Oh boy, this is gonna make me so late. Okay. I give up. There's no way that's gonna take me like 30 minutes. Nope, I'm gonna have to call an Uber. What are we on now? I think five. This last one for me is pretty big. This is not the last one, but that would be the lack of Mother Nature. That goes for most cities. Of course, you have the parks, the lake, and truly, if I did not live right by the lake, I'm a 5 minute walk. I would feel so trapped, claustrophobic. Sometimes when you're in the city, it's like you're in a box because all the buildings kind of go all the way around. So living by the lake for me, it helps a ton. I love being able to get out. There are a couple forest preserves that are in the suburbs. You'd have to have a car. You have the beach. However, Lake Michigan, even in the summertime, is really cold, so getting in the water is pretty painful.
Head off! What? Don't get ready.
It's that cold?
It's so cold. It's fucking frigid.
Oh my god, absolutely not. Although Mother Nature is lacking here, Chicago is a very clean city. I've been to a lot of cities and Chicago is among one of the cleanest that I've ever been to. In my day, have seen some roaches in my own apartment. This past summer I didn't have one, but the first summer we moved here we did have. That was my first encounter with a roach. I have never had any other friends in Chicago that have had a cockroach in their apartment. And I love my apartment, so it was a freak accident, I feel like. And I have seen a rat. I've seen lots of rats in Target once, and that was...
Oh my god.
Something strange in your neighborhood. Who you gonna call? I felt kind of bad for the rat. He seems like a well-rounded rat, so I hope he survived, but I don't think he probably did. Next one. This one, I wasn't sure if I wanted to bring up or not. They just wanted to touch on it because I feel like Chicago is sort of, I mean, you hear it in the songs, you hear it on the news, only has a rep for crime, violence, and yeah, so I thought I would go into it. I think it just depends on the neighborhood you're in. In East Lakeview, I've never felt unsafe. I definitely have I don't get scared easily. Heard a lot of cars getting stolen stories, a lot.
Chicago police are coming up with a new strategy as the city is seeing a spike in carjacking.
More than 1,400 carjackings in 2020, which is a 135% increase.
Really just have to be aware when you're in the city, especially when you're at your most vulnerable, whether that be at night, places where people aren't around. You just gotta be careful and smart. Last but not least, transportation here. I think a lot of people would probably disagree with me, so I'll just give my side and then I'll give you why other people might think it's awesome here. Basically, looking at the CTA, it kind of sprawls out. It goes like this, goes like that. So you can't really go from like point A to point B without a lot of walking. You get really good at logistics when you're here and being very efficient in getting things done and having to map out your whole day before you go and run errands, because you want to make sure when you're in one part of town that you also accomplish all the other things that are in that part of the town. But more about the CTA, you're either going to be taking the L. It stands for the elevated train. You'll either be taking that, which is so packed when going to work. I did take the bus to work. I haven't had to take public transportation since March of last year, so. Good thing about public transportation though is it's really nice to, on your way to work, be able to read a book or honestly look at your phone and not have to worry about driving there. If you're close to the bus stop or an L, it's really nice because you just get right on a warm train. And there's two takes to it, really. And those are just the points to really think on when moving to the city. Those are things that I expected, but wasn't really that prepared for. If you're looking to come to Chicago, I hope it helps you maybe decide if you want to or not. Should you move to Chicago? Maybe. I don't know. You have to decide that. But definitely making decisions like that is really hard. So I wish you well decision making and a good day. Goodbye. See you in Chicago, maybe.